Andrea Murta, she's a North America director at JOTA. That's a Brazilian media and information company. Let's talk a little bit about the tone of the speech. I watched it. It seemed like the crowd very enthusiastic as he talked about tackling corruption. Of course, Operation Car Wash, that scandal just has riddled Brazil in many respects. How does he go about that?
About corruption, he has, for example, nominated for justice minister one of the heroes of the car wash operation, which was the judge Sergio Moro, who was responsible for some of the criminal investigations in Brazil that put a lot of very famous people in jail, including former president Lula. So he seems to be really serious about putting the anti-corruption agenda at the core of this new government. We'll see if this impetus continues and how he'll deal with the barriers that he'll certainly face once he's in government.
That's, of course, one of the challenges. He talked about unemployment, violence, infrastructure, education as some of the other challenges facing the country. How daunting is this job going to be? Because even when you look at unemployment, it's right around 12%. And some analysts say even if you really tackle it and do a great job, you're not going to get it into the single digits until about 2021.
It's going to be very difficult. Brazil has really big, big problems that a lot of people have tried before to pass some of the structural reforms that the country needs to move in a different direction and have failed, even when they had very high Congress approval rates and a good relationship with Congress. So it's vital to see how he will really deal with the congressmen in this new government. And like CGTV has been saying, it's one of the biggest challenges and one of the biggest questions is how this new style of government is going to pay out in Brazil. Because that's what he needs to do. Everybody in Brazil sort of knows and agrees that what needs to be the first thing to be done is to pass some of the structural reforms, including pension reform and tax reform, so that the economy can move forward and some of that unemployment, for example, starts to show some measure of recovery.
Some pretty fiery dialogue from him on the campaign trail. A lot of people saying homophobic comments, racist comments, sexist comments. How does he unite the country after that? And it didn't seem like he was backing away from some of those sentiments during his speech.
It doesn't seem like he's changing the rhetoric that much from the social divisions that were portrayed so openly during the campaign now that he's in fact in government. And that's also going to be a challenge, including because if you have a country that's very divided and very distracted, quote unquote, by the social divisions, it's much harder to get everything else that are on the economic agenda moving forward at the same time. It seems that from his speeches that he does plan to move forward an agenda that's very socially conservative, that's very right-wing. So he's keeping up with the promises that he made during the campaign, which might be great for his base, but is also very divisive. And Brazil is definitely not on the same page. Not everyone agrees with what needs to be done in that regard.
And in many respects, it's the end of an era. I mean, we've seen Michelle Temer, Dilma Rousseff, Lula da Silva. He's a total break with that. How is that going to go over in Brazil? I mean, obviously, some people looking for change. We saw that here in the United States. We're seeing that in a lot of countries and this embracing of a candidate who's a little bit different. How is that going to be accepted in Brazil?
We'll have to see how that goes. It's certainly, I think, from you know, 10,000 foot level, it's interesting to see a democracy as young as Brazil having a somewhat peaceful, at least, you know, orderly transition of power from someone that was on one side of the spectrum onto someone that was on the opposition. Of course, we had some period of time with a government that wasn't that much different from Jair Bolsonaro, at least not in the economic agenda. So Michel Temer, who was the president up until the transition today, even though he came to power not through an election, after an impeachment, he was not that different from Bolsonaro in terms of the economic agenda. There's certain things that he planned to do that Bolsonaro plans to continue exactly on the same path, like pension reform, for example. So that change is not that dramatic. The change that is more dramatic, I think, is on the values and on the social conservative that has been rising in Brazil. And what we all are waiting to see is whether or not the rhetoric that stoked the campaign and how it united certain people, at least enough people to get him to power, is going to continue to be represented in Brazil in the same way or in increasing levels as the government moves on, because there will certainly be conflict and there's an expectation of social conflict coming up.
We'll be watching it. Thanks so much for your observations. Appreciate it.
My pleasure.